Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. In this video, we are discussing about control structures, loop control structures. This is one of the important and hot core of the programming language. So, this video we are discussing now. Okay. So, I hope we take more time on taking videos, and we are taking n number of videos on loop control structures. We will cover maximum number of programs in this session. Okay, this is the only for basic info. Next video onwards, we are discussing with deeply in syntax and flowcharts, etc. in the later sessions. But initially, we are giving only basic input related to loop control structures. So, what we discuss in this video are nothing but loop control structures. Why use loop control structures? Advantages with loop control statements, difference between conditional and loop statements, loop Java for loop, while loop and do while loop, just small comparisons are required. Explain difference between while and do while, difference between while and while or do while and for, means while and for and do while and for will be discussed in this video. Okay, so now loop control structures, why use loops? Looping statements are statements execute one or more statements repeatedly several number of times. In Java programming language, there are three types of loops: while, for and do while. Why use loop? When you need to execute a block of code several number of times, then you need to use looping concept in Java language. I will tell you in detail. So, advantages with loop statements: reduce the length of the code, take less memory space, burden on the developer is reducing, time consuming process to execute the program is reduced. Okay, and difference between conditional and loop statements: conditional statement executes only once in the program, whereas looping statements executes repeatedly several number of times. Okay, so I will give you a small example to better understand the loop control statements. So let us example: A is one place and B is one place. From A to B, the distance is 10 kilometers. Okay. Now the challenge is one organization, XYZ organization, conducting a walkathon from A to B. Okay, so they are requesting the commission of police of a particular city, and they asked about this. They are explaining about the event and they are requesting them to ask. But that is the most of the people using that place, so that the commission of police is not accepting it, but they are providing an alternative to provide a circular or oval shape of the land place. It is of 2 kilometers. Okay, then they start thinking that they are doing 5 times. Obviously, the purpose will be solved. It means that if it is enough space, we can move in a free direction. But if we didn't have enough space, then what we plan? We need to run or walk 5 times to the 2 kilometers. Obviously, it reaches 10 kilometers of walkathon. Okay, this is what exactly how we are repeatedly using it. This example gives more meaning related to that. Okay, so the next part is comparison regarding for loop, while loop and do while loop. Introduction: the Java for loop is a control flow statement that iterates a part of the programs multiple times. In Java, while loop is a control flow statement that executes a part of the programs repeatedly on the basis of given boolean condition. Okay, do while statement, the Java do while loop is a control flow statement that executes a part of the programs at least once, and the further execution depends upon the given Boolean condition. When to use? If the number of iterations is fixed, it is recommended to use for loop. If the number of iterations is not fixed, it is recommended to use while loop. If the number of iterations is not fixed and you must have to execute the loop at least once, it is recommended to use the do while loop. Then the syntax, in detail we will discuss, but these syntaxes are little bit considerable for this. Okay, for if you take any loop, three things are common. One is initialization, second one is condition, and third one is the iterator. In detail, in the next video, we are discussing about syntax and flowcharts of while, do while, and for in detail. And the next is, we are giving one example, and syntax for infinite loops, no condition, no initialization, no iterator, automatically it is infinite loop. While true we use, and automatically it is infinite loop. Do while true, it is an infinite loop. I hope you understand the basic needs of the things. Now, difference between while and do while. In while, and one side is while and second side is do while. In while, condition is checked first, then statements is executed. Statements is executed at least once, thereafter condition is checked. It might occur statements is executed 0 times if condition is false. At least once the statements is executed. No semicolon at the end of while condition. Semicolon at the end of the while condition. If there is a single statement, brackets are not required. Brackets are always required. Variable in condition is initialized before the execution of loop. Variable may be initialized before or within the loop. While loop is entry controlled loop, do while is edges control loop, and followed by the syntaxes are mentioned. Okay, so similarly, the next one is difference between while or do while and for. In this screen, we are discussing about for loop and do while loop, and the next for loop with while loop. Statements is by are executed once the condition is checked. Condition is checked after the statements is executed. It might be that statements get executed 0 times. Statements is executed at least once. For the single statement, bracket is not compulsory. Brackets are compulsory. Initialization may be outside or in condition box. Initialization may be outside or within the loop. For loop is entry controlled loop. Do while is the edges control loop. So followed by the syntaxes are mentioned. Okay, so now the last one is for loop and while loop. The difference between for loop and while loop. Initialization may be either in loop statement or outside the loop. Initialization is always outside the loop. Once the statement is executed, then after increment or decrementation is done. Increment or decrementation is done before or after the execution of the statements. It is normally used when the number of iterations is known. It is normally used when the number of iterations is not unknown. Condition is a relational expression. Condition may be expression or non-zero value. It is used when initialization and incrementation or decrementation is simple. It is used for complex initialization. For is entry control loop, while is also an entry control loop, and followed by the syntaxes are discussed. So, my dear viewers, this is the very, now onwards, the concepts are very, very important. Okay, so why? Because while, do while, and for, you know very well, you are the best and master in programming language. Okay. So that is what exactly I need to say. So today what we discussed is, one is loop control structures and why use loops, advantages with loop statement, difference between conditional and loop statement, Java for loop versus while loop versus do while loop, difference between while and do while, difference between while and while or do while and for. Thank you.